Hi, this is Mike Elliott, and you're watching the CEO Live Investor Insight Series. We're joined today by Frank Reynolds, who is the Chief Executive of InVivo Therapeutics, a $116 million medical device company focused on developing the first treatment for traumatic spinal cord injury, as well as a new range of platform technologies to treat other types of neurotrauma. Good morning, Frank. Thanks for joining us.
Great to talk to you again, Mike.
Last week, you released a letter to shareholders, which I want to cover. But first, many investors are interested to know where InVivo stands with the FDA regarding its biopolymer to treat acute SCI. So could you just tell us a little bit about that first?
Yeah, sure. So based on our meetings with the FDA, we certainly expect to start early next year. We did have an excellent meeting with the FDA back in April. We came out of that meeting with a number of things. You know, one was a clear pathway to get this first study started. Again, it's the first time a biomaterial is ever going to be placed in the spinal cord, you know, of a human being. We want to make sure that that material is, of course, safe, non-toxic. You know, nobody's ever made a non-toxic material for use in the spinal cord. And of course, we have. We filed patents on it. And we've even patented the manufacturing process. So again, we're prepared to start early next year. We're in the process right now of getting our GMP manufacturing facility up and running in Cambridge. As soon as we produce a few batches and get that data to the FDA, we believe we'll be ready to start.
And with regards to InVivo's stock right now, would you say it's undervalued?
Yeah, we're obviously disappointed. You know, obviously there were some unsubstantiated internet rumors. We believe that took the stock price down. The decline is certainly unwarranted. You know, we've been working now for many, many years at a very low burn rate. You know, our return to investors has been almost 600%. You know, in our last reporting, we've only spent about $19 million a day, and our market cap's over right around $116 million. But we've been returning value to the investors for a long time, and we were saddened to see the recent stock price drop, certainly unwarranted based on unsubstantiated rumors. But, you know, we're going to continue to drive value for our shareholders. We have multiple products. You know, our second product has already started the process at the FDA. But we have additional products coming for fibrosis, which is a huge area in medicine, multiple tens of billions of dollars opportunity there. And then we also have a new exciting gel for spinal cord injury. We've got some exciting preliminary data on that. We're looking forward to engage the FDA with that. But, you know, we're very excited about the financial performance of our company to date. We have 2 years of cash. I know that a lot of people are saying, what happens if this doesn't work? Well, we do have many shots on goal. You know, basically fixed costs going forward on human studies. Most of the costs are fixed. So we'll be able to handle a number of human studies, years of cash. Of course, we've had very promising preclinical data, so we're not expecting to have to take multiple shots on goal for the products. But if that was the case, we were certainly well-funded to do it.
And so back to the letter to shareholders. Let's start off with financial highlights. You mentioned a couple just now. What are some of InVivo's greatest strengths right now from a financial perspective?
Yeah, so number one, clearly our cash position is strong. Number two, the way we've historically used our cash. You know, I can tell you I got our first monkey study completed after spending only $1.3 million. You know, in bringing our new talent on, we've been building a team. We've been kind of switching out some of the early stage costs for some later stage costs, which have been somewhat similar. So, you know, we haven't seen an explosion in our burn rate. Our burn rate stayed relatively the same. So obviously we have plenty of cash. We're keeping our costs down. And financially, that's going to be a big return for our investors. You know, we do expect a lot of near-term value-creating events, including the submission and publication of our latest primate study data that really confirms for us conclusively that spontaneous recovery did not occur in the monkeys, and the monkeys' recovery is clearly because of our device being there. So that's very powerful. And of course, we have additional data coming out on other studies involving chronic pain, involving even our injectable for spinal cord injury and fibrosis. So, you know, a lot of value to be still unlocked. You know, at InVivo, every single day, you know, we talk about creating value and capturing value. And then, of course, we hope that all that value gets unlocked in the marketplace. And we think that as investors get to know our story a little bit, as we continue to deliver and execute on plan, people are going to really see a significant jump. Looking forward to, you know, the way we're executing on plan right now. I know we're going to discuss some of our operational strengths, but, you know, all those operational strengths run right into our financial strengths. So, you know, from all angles, we feel like we're firing on all cylinders.
And that you're exactly right. That is my next question. We led into it. Could you just give us a couple of what are, in your mind, kind of the biggest operational highlights from maybe the past 6 months?
Yeah, so clearly opening up our new 21,000 square foot facility, we had a beautiful ribbon cutting ceremony along with the government officials and wonderful letter of support from the Governor Deval Patrick. You know, the governor's been supportive of us for years. You know, this facility now provides us with the first real spinal cord injury research center that we've ever had access to. You know, we've outsourced our research over the last 6 years, and, you know, some of the centers we've had a compromise, you could say, in certain areas where we'd rather have You know, our own facility in-house where we control every aspect of the studies. You know, we have a chemical lab for all of our biomaterial manufacturing and or research and manufacturing. We have a chem lab, a bio lab for all of our stem cells and drug work. We have a vivarium. We'll have over 400 rodents under study at all times here. You know, just an exponential increase in the amount of research we're going to be able to do and produce going forward. So by far and away, the facility is the most important operational aspect of what's been going on at InVivo. But then the team behind it is even more important, I'd say. You know, we've repositioned our team to focus on biomaterial experts. We named Brian Hess our interim chief science officer, added Art Corey, who's brought multiple products to market in his 30-year career, putting a few hydrogels through Genzyme, and Bill D'Agostino, who's brought over 100 biomaterial products through market to market in the last 6 years. And I can tell you, we're very excited to have their expertise contributing every day. You know, it's a different skill set, you could say, biomaterials versus stem cells. And, you know, we're working on, of course, regenerative technologies. But everybody knows our neuroprotection and biomaterials are the foundation for our whole company going forward. But with that, of course, we have millions of people in wheelchairs that are looking forward to our technology coming forward in the regeneration space. And in order to provide them with a new opportunity, we've actually started our first chronic rodent injury population. So we have a large population of rodents that have been paralyzed recently, and we're going to be using them in chronic injury research over the next year or so. And that's never been done. Most research we see in spinal cord injury are really in the acute population. And I'm not sure of another center anywhere in the world that has a population of chronic rodent spinal cord injury animals waiting to be used in some of their studies. So anyway, that's a real value for us, you know, having that center in-house, the team in-house to execute on plan, but also to now create that population for our chronic, you know, regenerative technologies, we think is a bonus for everybody.
Well, it sounds like you've really set the stage for ongoing financial and operational success for certainly for the remainder of this year and well into next year. And that's all the time we had for questions today, but were there any comments you wanted to add before we close to kind of wrap up?
Yeah, no, I just say that, you know, we're obviously firing on all cylinders. It was kind of sad to see the stock performance, but, you know, that decline we believe was unwarranted. It was based on some internet rumors that are unsubstantiated. Anybody that comes to our facility sees that, you know, we've really put together an incredible team. You know, we won important scientific awards like the Apple Award last year in 2011, and we're looking forward to more awards to come. But, you know, if investors continue to be patient with us, we think that 2013 is going to be a significant year for everybody.
Frank, thanks again for joining us.
Thank you very much for having me again, Mike.
We've been speaking with Mr. Frank Reynolds. He's the CEO of InVivo Therapeutics, ticker symbol NVIV. To find out more about InVivo, please visit their website at www.invivotherapeutics.com. Thank you.